In the Midwest right now, new video has been coming into our newsroom all night. The storm packing wind gusts of up to 100 miles per hour. It blew through the heartland last night and into this morning. We have seen an unprecedented December. The tornado activity alone in Minnesota, straight line winds, a dust storm, and the weather is not over yet. We want to get over to meteorologist Gerard Jabaly for a closer look at the damage and exactly what's ahead today. Gerard?
Adrian, you're right on. This storm is unprecedented because it's pretty rare to see this kind of severe weather this time of the year and this far north. And this morning, Minnesota is reporting the first December tornado on record. At this hour, the power is out for nearly 500,000 people across 5 states, and it's all because of damaging wind gusts, some reaching over 100 miles per hour. Nebraska State Patrol dash cam video captures a semi toppled to its side just outside of the state capital of Lincoln. On the north side of Chicago, a tree is strewn across the street, landing on multiple cars. A doorbell camera shows a tree coming apart at its roots before slamming to the ground in western Kansas. And dust and smoke from a fire sweep through the Oklahoma Panhandle. In Chicago, a strong smell of smoke in the air from fires 650 miles away in Russell, Kansas. States throughout the heartland experienced record warm temperatures in the 70s, fueling a potent weather system, causing residents to take cover from destructive winds, severe thunderstorms, and tornadoes on Wednesday night. A slew of weather alerts impacting more than 100 million Americans. In Kansas, one of the hardest hit states, highways and an airport shut down due to high winds and dust storms causing near zero visibility on Highway 83 just east of the Colorado border. While December tornado threats are rare in the upper Midwest, Wednesday's system was unprecedented. The National Weather Service in the Twin Cities reported Minnesota's first ever December tornado. According to the Storm Prediction Center, there were 21 reported tornadoes in all, including one that hit this farmstead in Atlantic, Iowa. We heard the word derecho. A derecho is defined as an area of damaging winds that extends for over 250 miles, has consistent wind gusts of around 58 miles per hour or greater, and it has to have very well-separated gusts of 75 miles per hour or higher. Now, the costliest severe thunderstorm event in history occurred just last year in August of 2020, where a derecho blasted through Nebraska, Iowa, and Illinois, causing $11 billion in damage. So this is one of those events once again, and there is the radar loop of what we saw yesterday, and it was quite powerful, quite widespread. We saw a lot of damage across a lot of areas. All right, wind alerts right now. High wind warnings across parts of eastern Wisconsin, western and northwestern Michigan. Wind advisories out for the rest of those states here, so we still have some more wind to go, but the amount of wind and what we saw was pretty unreal. We saw gusts well over 100 miles per hour in spots. Lincoln, Nebraska recorded a wind gust to 93. Omaha, 74. Kansas City, 77. Gust to 84 there in La Junta and Garden City. As you notice, that is not the only places we saw that, but there are some of those numbers right there we talked about, even here in Chicago, 66 miles per hour. This is the 100 mile per hour club. Several places recording 100 mile per hour wind gusts, and some of that occurred outside of thunderstorms. Pretty incredible. Look at the carpet bombing that this storm system did with all the severe weather reports. Over 500, we're nearing 600 at this hour. And well, that's just the severe weather reports. The ones that occurred outside of thunderstorms still cause a lot of damage. I've never seen this before. This is absolutely unreal. Adrian?
All right, thank you. Of course, we'll continue to watch the weather this morning in the middle of the country. Meanwhile, thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.